Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to the subject Electromagnetic Field Theory. With this video, we are going to start with the new chapter, that is Uniform Plane Waves. And the first topic is Maxwell's equation in phasor form. Up till now, into the previous chapter, we have seen the Maxwell's equation for time constant fields, or also called time invariant field, along with another set of Maxwell's equation for time varying fields. Our subject is electromagnetic field theory, and we know that the common example of this electromagnetic field is electromagnetic wave. So with this video, we are going to see exactly what the electromagnetic wave look like when we have the electric field produced because of the static charge and the magnetic field produced because of the current. So now let us see the Maxwell's equation in phasor form topic. So Maxwell's equations are a summary that we have learned for electrostatics and the magnetostatics laws and theorems. Right from the Gauss's law and the Ampere circuital law, we have the Maxwell's equation. So first of all, for time constant fields, I will revise the Maxwell's equations. For time constant fields, we have the integral form as well as the point form of equations. The Maxwell's first equation is represented by del bar cross of h bar will be equal to j bar. Into the integral form, this can be represented as closed line integral h bar dot of dl bar will be equal to surface integral j bar dot of ds bar. So here h bar is magnetic field intensity, and we know that into the circulation of magnetic field, we have the curl of h bar to be the non-zero equal to j bar, that is cross-sectional current density. Moreover, we can say this is conduction current density. Now into the second equation, as we have obtained the first equation from Ampere circuital law, the rotation type of magnetic field represents from this representation. We try to have curl of electric field intensity, but it is not having any kind of rotation, hence the outcome is equal to zero. In the integral form, the closed line integral E bar dot of dl bar will be equal to the same RHS equal to zero. Whereas the Maxwell's third equation was del bar dot of D bar is equal to rho V. Here we have divergence of electric flux density D bar equal to volume charge density rho V into coulomb per meter cube. Into the integral form, as we have taken this from to the Gauss's law, we can have closed surface integral D bar dot of ds bar is equal to volume integral, it will be rho V into dV. Now the fourth equation, we have del bar dot of capital D bar, and this was equal to zero. As we don't have any kind of divergence into the magnetic field, we have only the circulating type of magnetic flux represented into the equation number one. Hence, to the integral form also, we have closed surface integral B bar dot of ds bar is equal to zero. We can state that the net outflow of magnetic flux into a closed surface will be equal to zero. So this was for time constant field. From time constant field, we have switched to the time varying field, where we had to modify equation number one and equation number two from this set. The modifications were into the Maxwell's first equation, the del bar cross of h bar was not satisfied to be equal to j only, we have to add one more term, so that we have obtained del bar cross of h bar is equal to j bar plus del d bar by del t. It is the time derivative of electric flux density, that we can also term to be j bar plus j suffix d bar. It is the displacement current density. Hence the equation becomes del bar cross of h bar is equal to the addition of these two current densities. Into the integral form, we can show closed line integral h bar dot of dl bar will be having the surface integral of the addition j bar plus del d bar by del t dot product with ds bar. Now the second equation, as the fields are varying, so that time the del bar cross of E bar is not equal to 0, we obtain it to be equal to negation of the time derivative of magnetic flux density B bar. So it was minus del del t of B bar into the integral form, we can write closed line integral E bar dot of dl bar will be equal to surface integral in negation or del B bar by del t into dot product of ds bar. Rest of the two equations, that is equation number 3, divergence of D bar is equal to rho v, that is point form of Gauss's law, and the integral form closed surface integral D bar dot of ds bar is equal to volume integral rho v dv. And the fourth equation, that is divergence of capital B bar magnetic flux density equal to 0 in the integral form, the closed surface integral B bar dot of ds bar will be equal to 0, remain unchanged. So the modified equations are equation number 1 and 2. So these are the time varying fields. These equations are applicable to time varying fields. So we have two set of Maxwell's equations, time constant fields and time varying fields. Now we require to get another form, that is Maxwell's equation into the phasor form. But before that, we will try to get to know what exact information is given to us from the previous set. Here on to the left hand side, we have H bar, that is magnetic field intensity, and onto the RHS we have D bar, that is electric flux density. So here the information can be like this: the time varying electric field produces the circulation of magnetic field, and from the second equation, the time varying magnetic field, this is magnetic flux density, produces the circulation of electric field. That is why we can say that the electric field parameters and magnetic field parameters go hand in hand, what we further call as electromagnetic wave. So the electromagnetic wave can be shown with this kind of simple model. So here I represent the three axes x, y and z, and if z to be the direction of propagation of wave, so we have two separate waves. First of all, this is to be the z direction, let us say this is to be the electric wave for the x direction, and this is to be the magnetic wave for y direction. So here electric wave can be shown like this. We have actually started from zero and we are going to repeat this particular structure along with the z direction. This is the origin, where the distance traveled is equal to also 0, the time instant is also 0, the phase is also equal to 0. So E bar is having the orientation of its vector along the positive and negative side of the x direction. The vectors we can show like this. So for positive part we have shown, for negative part can also be shown like this. Now the magnetic field will be having the orientation into the perpendicular direction with respect to the electric field wave. So it will have the orientation like this. It is into the yz plane, so that is horizontal type. The orientations will be like this. These lines are actually parallel to the y-axis. So the magnetic wave is into the horizontal plane and the electric wave is into the vertical plane. This is our electromagnetic wave. Electromagnetic wave. Now for this particular electromagnetic wave, we have the Maxwell set of equation for time varying fields. Now the time varying field Maxwell set of equation we have represented, and those set are this much. Here J bar we have represented simply by the symbol J only, the conduction current density, by using the Ohm's law. Here we can represent it further, that is del bar cross of H bar, for the point form only I represent, will be equal to J bar will be sigma E bar. J bar equal to sigma E bar plus it will be epsilon times del E bar by del T. Initially, the expression was like that, del bar cross of H bar is equal to J bar plus del D bar by del T. So the changes we have made, that J bar in terms of electric field intensity we have represented, D bar also we have represented in terms of electric field intensity, taking out the constant epsilon, that is permittivity of the medium. So this is first equation. The second equation, del bar cross of E bar, that we first of all denoted minus del V bar by del T, that we can represent in terms of magnetic field intensity, that is del bar cross of E bar will be equal to minus mu into del H bar upon del T. Rest of the two equations, divergence of D bar, del bar dot of D bar is equal to rho V, and divergence of B bar is equal to zero, remain unchanged. So this modified form we will be further utilizing to get the Maxwell set of equation into the phasor. So now into the previous diagram, I have shown you the electric wave and the magnetic wave that are going hand in hand, so that together forming electromagnetic wave. Now let us in general represent electric wave by either sine or cosine. I prefer the cosine here. So E bar can be represented as capital E0 time cosine of omega t plus phi. So in with respect to the phase, if you are talking about, so that time we have to take into the consideration the complex time plane. So thereupon we have the two axes, the real axis and the imaginary axis. The real axis will be represented like this, and the imaginary axis will be represented like this. So here the phasors can be represented. So the phase for this vector will be phi here. Now here if we again have the time harmonics, so it will be e to the power j omega t plus phi. So this kind of representation we can go on. So into the time complex plane, if we are representing, so we use the Euler's identity e to the power j theta. It is given by cos theta plus j sin theta. So using this particular Euler's identity, the generalized E bar vector, okay, will be represented as the real part of, in bracket here we can mention capital E bar or E0 bar, you can mention, is equal to e to the power j omega t plus phi. Hence further we can mention it to be the real part of capital E0 bar e to the power j phi into e to the power j omega t. Now e to the power j omega t represents the time harmonics of the electric wave. Actually, the Maxwell's equation are giving us the relationship between the time derivative and the spatial derivative. If you want to get into the spatial form, you have to suppress the time portion. But it is not so easy to suppress the time portion here. Hence, we try to represent it into the phasor form. So further, capital E bar in multiplication with e to the power j in bracket omega t plus phi, here we can represent capital E bar e to the power j phi and e to the power j omega t. So if we take E bar into e to the power j phi along with the phase, the together, so this is called as phasor, P-H-A-S-O-R. So this phasor, if you are representing, we can mention ES bar is equal to capital E bar into e to the power j phi. Therefore, the generalized representation we can make, the representation will be capital E bar will be equal to e to the power capital E bar in multiplication with e to the power j phi and e to the power j omega t will be simply represented as E suffix s into e to the power j omega t. This is the phasor form. Now the phases of time varying fields are represented with the suffix s here. The complex time variation we have represented with this term e to the power j omega t. Now we try to get the suppression of the time variations, but here we can mention it to the Maxwell's first equation. So Maxwell's first equation, del bar cross of h bar will be equal to sigma e bar plus epsilon times del e bar upon del t. Now this time differentiation, as we switch from the time domain to the phasor form for the complex domain, we try to switch del del t to j omega. Therefore, to the next step, we can mention it real part of del bar cross of the phasor hs bar into e to the power j omega t will be equal to the real part of sigma into es bar the phasor into e to the power j omega t plus j omega epsilon into es phasor into e to the power j omega t. Now we take out the real part notations here. Therefore, curl operation of the magnetic field intensity phasor into e to the power j omega t will be equal to sigma plus j omega epsilon into the electric field phasor vector. Therefore, the equation that we have e to the power j omega t and e to the power j omega t here also, we take out and write into the phasor form, that is del bar cross of hs bar will be equal to sigma plus j omega epsilon into es bar. So this is Maxwell's first equation in phasor form. So similar changes we can make to the time domain representations of later Maxwell's equation. And for the second equation, we can make del bar cross of e bar will be equal to minus mu del h bar upon del t. We can have the time derivative represented by j omega. Therefore, this equation becomes del bar cross of es bar into the phasor form will be equal to minus j omega mu hs bar. So this is Maxwell's second equation. The Maxwell's third equation, that was del bar dot of d bar is equal to rho v, we can simply represent, that is del bar dot of ds bar, that is into the phasor form, is equal to rho v. And the last equation, del bar dot of b bar equal to 0, we can have simple representation, del bar dot of bs bar will be equal to 0. So these are the Maxwell's equation into the phasor form. Now we want the application of Maxwell's equation into the phasor form for the charge free region, sometimes we call the free space. Hence we can have the set of equation for general conducting medium and the free space. So for general conducting medium, the Maxwell's equation in phasor form, the set I write, that is del bar cross of hs bar will be equal to sigma plus j omega epsilon e s bar. The second equation, del bar cross of e suffix s bar will be equal to minus j omega mu into hs bar. The third equation, del bar dot of ds bar will be equal to rho v, and del bar dot of bs bar will be equal to 0. So for general conducting medium we have these relations. And for free space not having any free charges, we have to make conductivity is equal to 0. Also, there is no charge distribution, hence rho v is equal to also 0. The corresponding changes if we make, we obtain the corresponding changes if we make, we obtain del bar cross of hs bar will be equal to j omega epsilon es bar only. Del bar cross of es bar we obtain minus j omega mu into hs bar, and del bar dot of ds bar that will be equal to 0. Also del bar dot of bs bar will be equal to 0. So these are the very important relations that we are going to further use to derive wave equations. So up till now, we had only two set of Maxwell's equation, one for time constant field, also called time invariant, then a time varying field. This is for Maxwell's equations for phasor form in general conducting medium, and this is Maxwell's equation for phasor form in free space, charge free region. So we have four sets of Maxwell's equation. We will be carrying the last set, that is for free space, to carry forward for wave propagation. Because one thing should be remembered, that the electromagnetic wave does not penetrate or propagate inside the perfect conducting material. Into the non-conducting material only we have the proper propagation of the electromagnetic wave. So into the next video, we will be starting to derive the wave equation for general conducting medium and further for perfect dielectric medium. For getting such more information onto the subject electromagnetic field theory, you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.